Good morning. Today we want to see the book of John chapter 21. John chapter 21 from verse 15. I will read. John chapter 21 from verse 15, I will read. When they had finished eating, Jesus says to Simon Peter, Simon, son of John, do you truly love me more than this? Yes, Lord, he said, you know that I love you. Jesus said, feed my lambs. Again, Jesus said, Simon, son of John, do you truly love me? He answered, yes, 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 Lord, you know that I love you. Jesus said, take care of my sheep. The third time he says to him, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter was hurt because Jesus asked him the third time, do you love me? He said, Lord, you know that, you know all things. You know that I love you. Jesus said, feed my sheep. Amen. Today we want to see this Jesus resistance reinstates Peter. So this is what kind of environment was it? Jesus, after Jesus resurrected, and then the disciples, they lost their Lord. Their Lord died, and then even though Jesus appeared before them a few times after Jesus resurrected, but then the disciples, they were really discouraged, and then they went back to the world to fish, to catch the fish. 3 years ago, until 3 years ago, they were the fishermen. When we look at the first part of chapter 21, then we can find they went back to the world again. They went back to catch the fish in the world. They were really, they lost their Lord. They lost their way. And then they lost their hope in God. As Jesus died, it was the end. And then they went back to the world. But then their life was still empty. No fish. No fish in their net. But then even at this time, Jesus appeared before them again from far. On the seashore. And then Jesus told them, you need to put your net on the right side. Throw your net on the right side of the boat, and you will find some. So they, even though until this time, then they did not know it, but then they just obeyed. Obey this person's, this stranger's instruction. And then they changed their direction from the left to the right. And then they could catch a lot of fish. They could catch a lot of fish. And then one of them, he realized who this person is. He is Jesus. He is our Lord. And then all other disciples, they could also realize it. Ah, he is our Lord. He is our teacher. He is our Lord. And then they came to Jesus. They were very surprised. And then they ate breakfast together. Jesus already prepared the bread and fish for them. And then they ate breakfast. Jesus, verse 13. Jesus came, took the bread and gave it to them, and did the same with the fish. This was now the third time Jesus appeared to his disciples after he was raised from the dead. So they could have the fellowship, table fellowship. They broke the bread together with Jesus. And then maybe they could also realize that Jesus is alive. Jesus is alive. Come and have breakfast. So Jesus welcomed them for the breakfast. I think they should be very hungry. And then, not just be physically hungry, but then their heart was empty, their life was empty. But then as Jesus came back to them after he resurrected, then Jesus welcomed them to the breakfast. And then they had the breakfast together. Jesus broke the bread. Took the bread and gave it to them. And with the fish, he did it the same with the fish. So, what kind of environment would it be? They could be also very encouraged. Or they could be also very sorry to Jesus. While Jesus was suffering on the cross, nobody was with Jesus. Peter denied Jesus three times. That's how they were. And Jesus died alone on the cross. So, most probably they were very sorry to Jesus. Another thing is they were also very surprised. Jesus is alive. Jesus is alive. They were very surprised, amazed by this Jesus resurrection. Even Jesus is eating with us. The same like us. He is eating with us. They were also very surprised. And then they could be also very comforted. Isn't it? They could be also very comforted. Jesus is alive. Right? He died, isn't it? Yeah, he died, but he is alive now. They were very comforted by Jesus' resurrection. And then they were very sorry. Even though they ran away, leaving Jesus alone. They denied Jesus three times. But then Jesus did not rebuke them. Jesus did not punish them. Instead of punishing them, Jesus came back to them. Jesus welcomed them for the breakfast. Right? Yeah. Jesus welcomed them for the breakfast. instead of punishing them, instead of rebuking them, Jesus welcomed them for the breakfast. This is the great love of God toward the disciples of Jesus, toward the sinners. They were the sinners, still sinners. They were still weak. That's why they ran away. They were not together with Jesus while Jesus was suffering a lot. But Jesus came back to them. Jesus was encouraging them. Isn't it great? Yeah. Even though Peter denied Jesus 3 times, but Jesus came back to him. And Jesus did not ask him, why did you deny 3 times? Jesus could ask him, the normal people. But then Jesus did not ask him, why did you deny 3 times? Jesus did not ask him, why did you commit sin? Jesus did not ask him. But just quietly, they were eating with Jesus. Jesus gave them the bread and fish. And then they were eating. Maybe they could realize the great love of Jesus Christ for them still. They could also realize the great forgiveness of Jesus for them. That's how maybe God loves us. We are the sinners. We fail. As we are living in the world, even though we are working for God, many times we fail. Or we deny Jesus. But then, the love of God is this. Jesus came back to them. Jesus comes back to us. Jesus wants to recover our faith. Jesus wants to recover our life. This was the great love of Jesus. Jesus loved them. Still. Even though they were the run, they ran away. But Jesus understood. Still, Jesus loved them. And Jesus did not rebuke them. But then Jesus was trying to recover their faith. So, they could be recovered. They could be recovered. And after the breakfast, Jesus asked Peter, when they had finished eating, Jesus says to Simon Peter, Simon, son of John, do you truly love me more than this? Simon, do you love me? Do you love me more than this? Yes, Lord, he said. You know that I love you. He didn't say that then, I love you. But he said that then, you know that I love you. Maybe he could not really also be sure of himself. He could not really say with surety himself. Because he failed. Before Jesus died, he was sure. He said surely, Don't worry, I will be with you until the end. Jesus, I can die with you. But then, could he keep his word? He couldn't keep his word. That's why he could not say with surety himself. That's why maybe he said that, yes, Lord, you know that I love you. You know that I love you. They knew that then Jesus loves them. And then Jesus was asking them again, do you love me? As I love you, do you also love me? Do you also love me? Then Peter answered, yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Then, feed my lambs. If you love me, feed my lambs. You need to feed my lambs. If you love God, if you love Jesus, what do God expect from us, from our life of faith? Maybe this is the one. Feed my lambs. We need to take care of the lambs of God. And then Jesus asked him again, Simon, son of John, do you truly love me? Do you truly love me? Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Then Jesus said again, take care of my sheep. Take care of my sheep. Still Jesus said again, the same word, one second time. Do you truly love me? Truly, he added a word. Truly. Yes. Do we really truly love God? Maybe God can ask us. Now how can he answer? Yes, Lord. Yeah. Maybe we can answer, yes, Lord. You know that I love you. And then what would Jesus ask us? Take care of my sheep. Take care of my sheep. Jesus still asked them to take care of the sheep of God. The lambs in the world. And then Jesus asked him the third time he says to him, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter was hurt because Jesus asked him the third time, do you love me? Then he said, Lord, you know all things. You know that I love you. Then Jesus said the same word. Feed my sheep. Feed my sheep. So, as we look at this story, as we meditate this story again, then, firstly, we want to realize how Jesus loved his disciples, how God still loves us. We want to realize it again. God loves us. Even though many times we go back to the world, we deny Jesus, we deny God. But then, Jesus came back to them. First, it's not that they came back to Jesus, but Jesus came back to them. The same, maybe God is coming to us again. God comes back to us to recover our faith, to recover our love. So we need to realize this first. Still, God wants to come back to us while we are in the world, in the sea, to catch the fish, But maybe God still wants to find us, want to come to us to find us again. And then maybe God can also invite us to the breakfast with Him. So you want to realize this again. Still, God is finding us. God wants to recover our faith. And then second one is, if we love God, if we believe that God loves us, then if we can also love God, if we love God, then what should we do? We need to take care of the sheep. We need to feed the lambs in the world. That's how we can show our love toward God. We can live loving God. And then we can also live loving our neighbors with the love of God for our life. So at this time, we want to realize it again that God still wants to come back to us. God still loves us, recover us, recover our faith, recover our love. And as we love God, we also want to do the God's will. We want to live according to God's will for our life, taking care of the sheep, feeding the lambs in the world. So, and then we also want to teach the people, especially teach the disciples, leaders, the young leaders, what they should do for their life. If they love God, firstly, we need to teach them. We need to let them know that God loves them. And then, what do we need to teach them? We need to teach them to take care of the sheep, to also feed the lambs. So as we meditate this word, then we also want to, we want to realize it again that, again, the great love of God for our life. And then we also want to live according to His will for our life. So we want to end here. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for allowing us this time to meditate your word. Jesus, as Jesus rose from the dead, even though his disciples ran away, his disciples denied Jesus, but then Jesus, instead of rebuking them, punishing them, but Jesus came back to them, and then Jesus wanted to recover their faith, recover their love, as Jesus showed them His great love still for their life. Even Jesus welcomed them for the breakfast. And then maybe they could be recovered in God. That's how maybe God wants to come back to our life. God wants to recover us, recover our faith, and recover our love toward God for our life of faith. And then Jesus asked them to take care of the sheep in the world, to feed the lambs in the world. So as we love God, we also want to do the will of God for our life, to feed the lambs, to take care of the sheep in the world, to guide many to God, to teach many with the word of God, with the true word of God. And then through our life, the great will of God can be fulfilled in this world. So please be with us. Please guide each one of the members in our church. So then we want to realize this, your great love for us again. And then we also want to live following your will for our life. So thank you for all your grace through this time. Then I pray all this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. And thank you very much. God bless you all.